New Delhi Institute of Management is honored to have Her Excellency Ms. Mariana Cruz Alvarez welcome you to NDIM, ma'am. And I feel so privileged to have a conversation with you today. Questions or steps do you think management, faculties, and students should take to adapt to the increasing system of the education, the changes in the education system? What, according to you, that you think the management, faculties, and students can do about it?
For the younger generation, new generation, your views about it, that's what she wants to know.
Yes, well, I do think that ethics is the main subject, because if we give the students foundation, they will know how to consciously go into technology. Because technology now, the internet is so, it's dangerous. It's a dangerous environment. If unsupervised, or if children or the students don't have the right, let's say, values. So value education for me would be the most urgent thing. And of course, you know, families working with the education system so that we can protect our kids. That's amazing.
That's right. Right.
Truly, that's nice.
I agree with you. Yeah.
But what type of human values and ethical formation do you have in this institute?
Yeah, we have a full-fledged subject here, you know, where we teach business ethics. Right, so we tell them like what are do's and don'ts in the corporate, and then they merge out as a good human beings as well as good managers.
Yes.
We do that. Yeah.
And also we are made acquainted with the CSR, corporate social responsibility. Like how can you give back to society as a human and as a part of the corporate world?
That's the selfless part. Yeah, but I do think that, like, for example, in my law school in Costa Rica, in 5 years of studies, I only received one subject on ethics. That was very, like, nothing. So I had to do my own research and find my own, you know, how to apply, especially, you know, the lawyers. It's
not
a touchy subject.
So any suggestions or advice you have for the next 10 leaders, for people like me, you know, who want to be the leaders in the future?
It's about connected people, and that everybody grows and everybody has like mutual respect for the cultures. You're talking internationally, but it's not about like robbing people or about like abusing. You have a very powerful instrument in your hands to create more abundance for more people, but not only for yourself. For yourself as well, because you need a living, but you know, you need to share that
opportunities.
And actually, like in America right now, there are many companies that are giving back. Like I think, for example, one of my sons is involved in this climbing gym. And they have like a social part, where they, you know, and they go to the mountains, they do their climbing exercises and everything. But then they have like a social, like, area in the business. So those companies that are organic, those companies that are supporting environment, those companies that are sharing their wealth with people in need, are the companies that are like going up, especially, you know, with environmental issues. And
whatever time you spend with us right now, so how do you feel about it?
I love it so much that I want to bring a delegation from this. I think it's a wonderful idea, because we have signed several MOUs with different institutions, but as your chancellor said, they become like dead paper. What this event showed me is that what about bringing the students to India? What about bringing the teachers and having the MOU as an excuse for the exchange of culture, of like, you know, creation of friendships, and then your students can go to Los Angeles, and then they can come to Costa Rica. Because I think for your generation, what you need the most is to travel. You need to travel the world, get out of India, because India can become very cozy. The same thing that happened to me in Costa Rica. And there's a lot happening. Latin America is a continent that is waking up. And we have the energy, we have the passion, India has the wisdom, but you know, we make a team, there's lots of good things, because we share common values, you know, we appreciate family, we have our devotion for either whatever the religion we have, but it's about like holding that foundation, but also growing together. So you need to come, you need to travel, all your friends. That's the first thing. Like my children, this generation, how they do it, they work, they travel. And then they save again, they work, and they travel. that's their lifestyle. They don't want to be, because they can work actually from anywhere, because they have their laptop.
Yeah,
so you can be in Costa Rica, you can be in LA, you can be in India.
You're from anywhere you like.
So that this technology gives us all a lot of freedom. So use it. Use it, but you can grow in a human way. Not only, like they were saying, you know, laugh to the computer. That's really sad. So the computer can know how you feel. That for me is pathetic. I mean, create meaningful relationships and nourish them by going to your friends, not only on the advice for you, like it used to be.
Yes.
That's
great. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah.